Hello and welcome back to the KCC channel. I'm Rob and I hope you are having a wonderful day today. Today, we're jumping into some malicious compliance. Our first story today comes to us from, this name right here. Stop treating me like a kid. Let's jump right in. This malicious compliance was on the part of my mom. It was almost 19 years ago now, but I thought you all might find it mildly amusing. I'm sure there are similar stories of parents doing this same thing. My youngest brother was lazy when he was in his early teens. This occurred during summer break from school. Our parents required us to be in bed at 10 p.m. on weekdays, even during breaks from school, since our dad had to leave for work at 5:30 a.m. This had been a rule for years. My mom was a stay-at-home mom who busted her butt doing household stuff for all of us that she didn't have to do, but she enjoyed seeing her family happy. My little brother had recently had his 14th birthday a couple days before, and was lucky enough to have been gifted an Xbox and two games he very much wanted. In our family, this was a big deal, because our parents, while not poor, weren't exactly flush with money and had saved up for it by cutting coupons and cutting back on luxuries they enjoyed. One day during this break, my 14-year-old brother was up playing his newly acquired Xbox still, hadn't gotten ready for bed yet, and it was coming up on 10 p.m. I had already gotten ready and was reading a book. Being in post-secondary at the time, I thought it common courtesy to be quiet since I'm living there for free. My mom tells my brother he has to go to bed and to please turn off the game. Suddenly, the Xbox seems to be the reason he didn't like the rules anymore. Mom, looking very annoyed at my ungrateful brother, tells him it's not an option and that he's going to bed now. But why does he get to stay up? That's not fair. He, as in me, his college-age brother. Because he's an adult, that's why, and you're going to bed this instant. No, stop treating me like a kid. I'm not a little kid anymore. I see my mom get a funny look on her face. She smiles. I have no idea what's going on at this point, and I'm pretty surprised because usually by this point, she'd bring down the sanctions hammer and possibly take away the Xbox. But she doesn't. She simply says, okay, and goes to the kitchen, where I see her whispering something to our dad, but I'm too far away to hear. Dad goes into the garage, where he keeps his woodworking stuff, and returns with earplugs in his hand, and our parents go to bed. I head to sleep almost an hour later. My little bro is still gaming away. The next morning, my little brother doesn't get up until just before noon and has some cereal. Then dinner time comes. Mom had made an eggplant casserole. My brother hated eggplant. Normally, she'd make something else for him. Not this time. Where's my food? Oh, there's some ingredients in the pantry for you to make dinner with. My brother ends up eating cereal again because he can't figure out what he's supposed to do. A few days later, he's got no clean clothes left. Mom, I have nothing to wear. Mom, smiling like the Cheshire Cat. I usually do my laundry on Fridays. Which day would you like to use the laundry machines? But how about Saturdays? They're free that day. Oh look, today is a Saturday. Feel free to use them. And she walks out of the room to go lay on the patio and read. As she goes through the kitchen, she passes by my dad and they both laugh. My bro continues to wear his clothes, saturated with teenage stank instead. Gross. At dinner, my parents announce they're taking us to a matinee showing on Sunday morning of Terminator. I think it was the third one. My brother really wanted to go. My mom said we'd like to go at 10 a.m. for the 10:30 showing. To the best of my memory, it was sometime in the late morning. Well, my little bro stayed up super late again playing Xbox. It was almost time to leave, and my brother still wasn't awake. Normally, our mom would have asked him to go to bed at midnight on a weekend, but dear malicious compliance mom decided she didn't feel like stressing herself out with arguing with him. As we're putting our shoes on, I go, hey, is it just us? Well, we all knew the time in advance. Don't worry, your brother will be fine. Dad smiles at my mom. He's gonna be so mad. The rest of us go enjoy the movie, including our other brother. Then our parents take us out to lunch. We get back home around 2 p.m. or something like that, and little bro comes practically running down the stairs, still in his stank butt clothes that haven't been washed, with tears in his eyes. How come you went without me? I wanted to see Terminator 2. That really sucks. The other adults went to bed on time. You asked me to not treat you like a kid anymore. Sorry that you missed it. Maybe if you ask the neighbors if they need their lawn mowed, you can make enough to buy a movie ticket and bus ticket to get there. He just looked at her and cried harder. My little bro and my parents went to talk. Apparently, my bro had cereal for lunch while we went to a sit-down restaurant, and he was salty about that too. That night, my brother went to bed at 10 p.m. sharp. As a bonus, mom taught him how to do his own laundry and basic cooking skills over the next month. He seemed happier, started thanking my mom on the time she did stuff for him, and my mom eventually told him she was really proud he decided to be respectful of the rest of the family. My parents were so happy about his change in attitude that my mom took him and a friend of his to see the movie. It was still playing in the cheap theaters. Well, OP, I like how mom allowed your brother to fail a little bit at home to realize just how much the adults actually do. Now, sometimes my kids will look at me and say, I can't wait to be an adult, and I just sit back and think, wow, you're in for a rude awakening. Do me a quick favor and take a look down below the video. If that subscribe button's still red, it means you're actually not subscribed to the KCC channel. Please hit that subscribe button for more daily Reddit stories. This next story comes to us from United States of... really? The lunch break is for eating, so go back to work. Let's jump right in. My ex-employer would send me out on errands all the time, to the point where my lunchtime was over by the time I got back to the office. Many times, I would usually skip out on lunch because I personally did not have an appetite. One day, I had to go submit some of the company documents somewhere, and we were understaffed. So we agreed it's best I go during lunchtime. I submitted the documents and grabbed some lunch from a takeaway. I did not eat the lunch. I simply got it in a takeaway bag and got transport to work immediately. I arrived with only 5 minutes to spare, and I was particularly hungry that day. I tried to eat as fast as possible, and she was just talking to me the whole time, so I can't chew and speak at the same time. At exactly 3:01, she tells me, "The lunch hour is for you to get lunch and eat it. If you cannot finish your food on time, don't eat it during work hours. Also, please refrain from eating in the work area." 1. I was eating by the microwave because we do not have a designated lunch area. 2. The store, place of employment, was completely empty. I could have used a good 10 minutes to finish up. 3. I didn't have time to eat because I was running your errands. Cue malicious compliance. One day, it was lunchtime, and I wasn't feeling particularly hungry, so I'm standing by the cash register. My boss rushes in, exclaiming how she has a lot to do and we need to get the stock out of her car as fast as possible so she can go to her next meeting. "Will somebody please help me?" No one responded. "OP, you'll help me get the stock out of the car, right?" "I would, but lunchtime is for eating." I took a piece of gum and a bottle of water and stood in the parking lot for the whole hour, watching her struggle with stock and look flustered. Not my problem. OP, never do work during a scheduled break, especially one that you're not being paid for. If it's an hour-long lunch break and you're not making any money, why would you continue doing things for the company? This next story today comes to us from Volden Nope. I have to squeeze past you to get off the bus? Okay, let's jump right in. This is my tiny malicious compliance story, which happened in my first year at uni about 8 years ago. The bus I, then 20 female, had to take to uni was the most popular route in town, meaning it was always packed. Because I got on at the first stop, I always had a window seat, which meant that someone was usually sitting next to me when I had to get off. And I had to do the awkward thing of lifting my backpack and straightening up in an exaggerated fashion to show them that they had to stand to let me pass. No problem usually. Just a bit awkward for socially awkward me. One morning, a guy in his 40s sat next to me and promptly manspreaded across my seat, pushing his leg right up to mine. I thought it was weird, but hey, maybe this guy had a painfully swollen scrotum or no self-awareness, or both. Anyway, I was giving him the benefit of the doubt, and as he was focused on his phone and ignored me, I did the same for the rest of the journey. Then, when we were getting close to my stop, I started the awkward, "I have to get off, so let me pass" show. no reaction. So I stood up from my seat. Still, no reaction. Sir, no reaction. I tapped his shoulder. Sir, I need to get off. Can you let me pass? The guy looked up at me and, with the widest, most disgusting grin, said, "Well, sweetie, looks like you're gonna have to squeeze past me. No problem for such a skinny girl, right?" Some of the passengers standing around us noticed and were about to intervene. But I was pissed, because at that point I had missed my stop, and I wasn't sure if he was a pervert or just liked to piss on people's days. But I didn't want him to win. Also, no one had ever called me skinny. I have what one would call childbearing hips, thank you very much. So I smiled at him and said, "Okay, have it your way." My backpack was filled with a half a dozen library books that I was going to return that day, and it was bulky and heavy AF. Usually, I would have put it on after leaving the crowded bus, but not that day. I shouldered my backpack so it was hanging at the right height, and clumsily, forcefully, and, just in case he was indeed a pervert, in no way sexually squeezed past the guy, dragging my huge backpack across his face. If I leant back to make sure to really get his nose, well, that surely wasn't intentional. And if he emitted any pain-fueled protests, well, they must have been muffled by my backpack. As I was standing by the door waiting for the next stop, I looked back to see him covering his nose with his hand. It looked like he was checking if it was bleeding, but I don't think he did. He might have had a scratch or two from my backpack, but he wasn't injured or anything. His pride was, though. He kept glaring at me for the glorious half minute it took for the bus to reach the next stop. I was in such a good mood that I didn't mind walking back to where I was supposed to get off. OOP, don't you wish this was one of those situations where you could fart on command, like cabbage smelling farts, you know, really crop dust them good on your way out? That would have been epic. This next story comes to us from Griselda Loves Cats. Don't even say hi to them. Let's jump right in. Many years ago, I was the junior manager at a restaurant known for sausage and older customers. A few weeks into my training, one of the senior VPs at the company decided to hire his mistress to redesign the decor in the stores in my area. Y'all, never ever let your side piece take part in your job. She had no qualifications and the worst taste. Truly abominable color and pattern combinations. Picture pink floral wallpaper, geometric orange carpet, and baby crap brown and green on the chairs and booths. I cannot adequately describe the atrocity of her designs. She also was moving display cases where things were in the kitchen and grill areas and more. All of this was to be done at night so that we didn't have to close during operational hours. I was the one who had to stay all night while they made all these changes. 2 weeks of working all night supervising. I was horrified at the plans and told my boss, who agreed with me. He then told me to just read a book or something, so I couldn't be accused of sabotaging the design. This had just happened at the two stores that were remodeled before ours was. My manager then told me I was not to even speak to the workmen unless they were taking food or restaurant supplies out of the building. I clarified that he meant not saying hi or anything else to them for any reason, including good manners or work that had a serious problem. Another manager got fired for talking too much with the workmen, and then objecting to the hideous new decor, because corporate was that awful to managers. A couple of nights later, I noticed that the workmen are obviously not doing things right, not because things looked hideous, but because they were doing a crap job of it. They had to move some of the electrical outlets, and several of them were smoking after they put the outlet covers on. They also shot sparks when you plugged anything in. I didn't say a word. After all, I wasn't allowed to talk to the workers unless they were stealing food or restaurant supplies. So, I ignored it. When the GM came in, he tried to plug in the calculator in the office that the workmen moved. It shot out sparks. He then asked me why I didn't inspect everything the electrician did and insist he redo the outlets because of the shoddy workmanship. He also got upset the day the wallpaper was hung. A couple of strips were upside down, the edges were curling, and overall it just looked horrible. The trim that they painted had lots of drips and splatters and missed spots. It was just a mess. Boss was far from happy that I didn't monitor the quality of the work, that I had no authority to do anything about. I was just there to keep them from stealing. I told Boss that he said I was not to talk to the workers unless they were stealing food or other restaurant supplies. I also mentioned that I was not a building or electrical inspector, so how should I know if they did a bad job? I didn't tell him that my parents taught me to redecorate and remodel. Dad was a shop teacher and does not see gender as a reason not to learn life skills. In our family, fixing it yourself is a life skill. When the district manager came in to see the final results, nothing was fixed because even my GM didn't have the authority to make the workers redo anything for any reason. He was furious. It really looked that bad. We had the CEO coming in to inspect later that day. It was awesome. I got called onto the carpet for allowing the workmen to do such a bad job. My GM's head exploded when I told the district manager that I was not even supposed to say hi to the workmen, much less criticize anything they were doing, per a direct statement from my GM. I did not get into any trouble, and the district manager thought it was hilarious, except for the part where we were left with a store that looked atrocious and had entire sections where the electrical work was bad enough that we were afraid the store would burn down. It legit was that bad. We got a new crew of workers, and I got to spend 10 more days supervising the workers. Easiest month on that job. Getting paid to read and chill and nap. Well, who wouldn't want that? OP, not gonna lie, when you first mentioned that there was a restaurant known for sausage and older customers, my mind went immediately to Chippendales, but I know that's not where this was going. I have one pretty big question about this story though. Where were the permits and the inspections afterwards? Because a big company with multiple locations would definitely have people come in to look at that stuff, right? Tell me they would. This next story comes to us from Biohazard5656. Just worry about your work and not mine. Let's jump right in. This was my first job in manufacturing, making laser in my 20s. The company was hiring a bunch of folks so they could start a second shift to make the order deadline. Plus, they had a new line coming into production, so they wanted senior staff on that and the new folks on the older line. I was around the first new people to get hired. I'm not a dumb person and take pride in my work. I also like helping others because, well, I'm not a piece of crap, but I'm also okay with letting people get what they deserve when they are not nice people. Anyway, a new guy gets hired to work next to me, and of course, it's someone much older, late 50s to early 60s, who worked at insert big company name here and didn't need to be told by me when he was messing up. He would make obvious mistakes that to fix would require you to disassemble it to fix it if you caught it later. I would see him make these mistakes and point them out to avoid the time needed later to take it apart and fix it. After a few times of pointing out his mistakes, he freaks out and says it was because of me that he was making these mistakes and that I should just worry about my work. And now, the malicious compliance. I eventually started working at the next step, where you filled the laser with gas and run it. The other guy built them and I ran them. Well, he was much slower at building them than I was, so naturally, we would have to wait. One day, I had no work and was told to just wait till he built the next laser for me. So I did, but here's the kicker. The step before him built it wrong. There were different features depending on the type of laser it was, and I could see that from a distance. Well, I waited over an hour for him to build this thing. He could see me and knew I was waiting on him. Finally, he finishes the laser and moves it to the shelf where I get them from. He doesn't say a word to me, but looks right at me like, "Here you go, you can finally do some work." I stand up, grab a yellow failure sheet, and start filling it out. I walk over to the laser, put the sheet in there, and walk away. Mind you, he was watching me the whole time. He gets up, reads the paper, turns to me and goes, "You knew this was wrong the whole darn time, didn't you?" Which I replied, "I'm just minding my own business, worrying about me." Another time, the lasers needed water to cool them and had hoses that were attached to the laser and the other to a quick release end. We didn't have air in our area to purge the lasers, so we needed to bring them to another area to do so. This was important if they needed to be taken apart, because there would still be water in there under pressure. Well, my cell lead failed a laser and just put it on the shelf to be taken apart. Now, I always would check the lines for water by pushing the nipple into a trash can, because it's the smart thing to do. Well, guess who didn't check when taking it apart? I got to watch water explode all over him as he took the water manifold apart. He turned to me, laughing of course, and goes, "You knew about this the whole time, didn't you?" To which I replied, "Again, I'm just worrying about me and minding my own business." He didn't see who failed the unit, so he immediately grabbed the sheet. I assumed to see if it was me and try to get me in trouble, only to find out it was the cell lead and couldn't do anything about it. Just because you're more than twice my age doesn't mean you know it all and can't make mistakes. The fallout. I got tired of working at a place that seemed to think older people were better than younger people when every mistake was his and not mine. I got a different job. OP, giving that failure notice without even testing the item he built, that was absolutely amazing. I can only imagine the look on his face when you walked over with that paper, put it on, and just turned around and smugly walked away. Well done. Check out all 5 OPs linked in the description down below. I thank you for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and we'll see you tomorrow.